So in this video, I'm going to show you how you can switch from one data source type to another easily. So let's say, for example, that you're connected to maybe some CSV or some XLS files, right? But, you know, that was just a temporary thing, and finally you got access to the SQL Server. That's where the files were being generated from. Maybe somebody else was dumping it for you, and now you have direct access to that SQL Server. Great. You know, more power to you, my friend, right? But now what you would want to do is you would want to switch your Power BI model easily, without having to redo a lot of work, from using these CSV or XLS files to directly using the SQL Server. Now, of course, what I'm going to show you and this scenario could apply when switching from any data source to any other data source. So let's take a look. So first thing, I'm going to show you two wrong ways of doing it, and then we're going to show you the right way of doing it. All right, so let's get into our query editor here. All right, so it's coming up. So the first thing that users look for usually, so in this case, if you notice that these are connected to XLSX, and you can look at it other ways. Sometimes I open the query dependencies view. I love that visual view. And it's, you know, it's the color is a little wonky. I'm not sure why, but yeah, you can hover over to see that it's coming from an Excel file and so forth. But often what people do is they would go to their data source settings and look for something there. Now, if it does seem promising, when you open data source settings, it's like, oh, cool, I want to change this. And there's this change source button right there, but it's not what you think it is. So in here, all you can do is pretty much, you know, it's got change data source. It can still be an XLSX file, but you can, if the location changed, then you can change it, right? But this is not going to let you switch to a SQL Server. So for that, there is another wrong way to do it, and let me demonstrate that. But that one is going to get really close, and there's just one small thing they need to switch. So in this case, right again, so this all of these tables are coming from Excel file. And you can see I have my whole model built, and if you quickly will switch over back to this, then I have my measures defined and all that sort of stuff and all my graphs defined, right? So it's good. Life is good, right? And I just want to switch from one source to another. So what you might do, some users do this, where they say, cool, I'm going to bring in the new table. So I'm connecting to my SQL Server here. And that asks me a few questions. There we go. So I'm just going to say, put the server name in, hit OK. And of course, in my case, it should pop up and asking me about the location of the file, which is right here. And I'm going to pick my sales table, which is right here. And I'm going to hit OK. And there. So now I have this table from the SQL data source. And this is where people go wrong and they say, cool, now I don't need this guy, right? So I don't need this guy. And because I have this one here, I'm just going to delete that one and rename this one to sales. So they might delete sales. And let's say, oh, cool. Now I can just come back here and click sales. And, you know, the column names and everything is exactly the same. The column names are the same. The data types are the same. Looks like we're good to go. Well, not quite. Let's see what happens. So once you hit close and apply, and it's going to load the table. And, well, okay, let's wait for that. Big finish. Boom. Yeah, so you saw it just broke about everything, and it's like, oh, well, the good news is that you're really close. So let me redo this and show you the right way to do it. All right, so I'm back. I undid a few steps, and so we're back before the critical step, right? So what we have here is this table is coming from SQL, and this is our old table connected to that, right? So you can see this one is connecting to my SQL database, and this one is sales. So the trick here, so of course, first thing you need to make sure is that column names and the data types and stuff, it matches, right? So everything just matches, right? So, but what you're gonna do is I want you to go to Advanced Editor and copy this whole thing and then go back and again, right, you can't delete the stable, right? So this is that what's connected to Power BI knows that, oh, that's the one that's loading here. It has the measures inside defined and all that stuff. So you can't delete the table and just rename this one. You saw what that did. But what you can do is totally change the guts of this. Like, so, you know, and of course, you know, so let me just show you. So you're going to go to advanced editor and these are the guts, right? This is what's connecting to Excel and so forth. And you can go in here and you can make any change you want. And of course, the change we're going to do is the M code that we had copied from here, we're just going to paste it here. So now it's pointing to the SQL server, but it is the same table. It is the same table. And I might have to rename this to sales. Let's just try it, see what it does. Oh, it keeps it, right? So yeah, you can just copy paste it. It kept that name. So again, you connect to this SQL set, and then you you know, go to the advanced editor, copy that code, and just paste it in here. And now sales, and you can see in the query dependencies view as well, the sales table, I apologize, some of the colors are a little wonky, but you can see here, so this is my SQL table, and sales is now connected to this, and that's it, that's all I want. Now, of course, you realize that we don't really need this table, now we're done with this, because the sales essentially is a copy of that, so we can delete this, and in this case, I only swapped this way one table. Of course, if you have other tables, you would repeat the same exercise for them, and at the end of it, you're going to hit a close and apply. And again, because we didn't like delete it or mess with it in any way, we just changed the guts, how it's connecting, Power BI is gonna be none the wiser, right? I mean, you know, it's like, oh, well, it's just, I don't know, it's the same table, same field names and everything, right? But so yeah, the load is gonna not gonna be disruptive. Notice that it's refreshing now, and yep, none of our graphs or measures or anything was impacted. All of the measures defined are still there. So that is the right way to change your data source. Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.